Yes, good afternoon, students. Let us get into the hands-on session of Java collections. As a first and foremost program, which we have discussed, is ArrayList. We have seen that ArrayList is the class that is implemented from the list interface. So let us get into the first program, that is ArrayList program. Let us have the program name as test java collection 1. So I have created this program under the package that is user defined package array list 1, so that we have the name package array list here, followed by we have discussed that all the collection are available under the common package, that is util package. So we have to import the java.util.star. So our program name, we have set our program name as test java collection 1, the same name as given to our main methods class name also. Let us have public static void main of, followed by the array list. The array list is the class, followed by the string is the data type, and list is the object, that is user defined object, new to allocate the memory. Again, array list string of, here the array list will act as a constructor. So now we will use the scanner class in order to get the input from the user. So scanner se is the object name, new scanner of system.in, that is the input is going to be received from system. After that, system.out.println, let us give them some message as enter the number of elements, that is the number of elements to be added to the list object will be received in the integer variable n. SE dot next int of is used to get the integer input through the scanner object SE. Now, through the for loop, we are going to get the input. That is, we are going to get n inputs, so that for I is initialized as 0, this loop will run till n times, that is 0 to n minus 1 times the loop will run. System.out.println of, we are going to give the message as enter 0th element, enter first element, enter second element, and so on. Now, in order to add the elements to the object, we are in need of method called as add method. So list is the user defined object name of array list class. Now list dot add of sc dot next of, next of will get the string input. Those input will be added to the list object. We have already discussed that in order to traverse the elements from the list, we are in need of iterator object. That is, iterator is the class. We have to create the object for iterator. Here, ITR is the user-defined object name. So list.iterator of, the iterator of is the method which is used to iterate the collection object. Here, list is the object. List dot iterator of, so that the reference will be given to iterator object ITR. While ITR dot has next of, the has next of method will return true till there is an element in the list. So while loop will be executed for each and every element available in the list object. Now system.out.println of, ITR.next of will return the element available that is referenced by the iterator object. Now let us execute the program. In order to execute the program, we have to press this green color arrow. Let us run the program. So the output window is visible at the bottom of the page. The message enter number of elements. Let us enter the elements as the number of elements as 3. Now the enter 0th element, we have to enter the first element. Let us add some first element as the ROM. Now we have to enter the 1th element, that is the second element we have to add. Let us add the element as something as agile. And we have to enter the second element, that is 2th element, that is at the question 2, we have to add the 3rd element. Let us add the 3rd element as Ravi. So now when you press enter, you will get all the elements one by one. Here the Ram, Ajay and Ravi. So the insertion order is maintained. The insertion.
Sir, your presentation is disconnected, sir.
Sir, wait a minute, sir.
Yes, sir, it is visible, sir.
Okay, sir. So through the iterator object, iterating the elements one by one. So we have already seen that, we have already discussed that the array list maintains the insertion order. The insertion order will be maintained so that the elements are stored in the same order. And also we have discussed that the duplication is allowed in array list. Let us execute the same program once again. Let us have one again 3 elements. Let us enter the 0th element as Ram. Let us add the first element is also as Ram. And let us add the 3rd element as something Ajay. Now the Ram and Ajay will be the output. The duplication is allowed in arrays. So when you use the linked list, the next concept which we have discussed is linked list. The linked list and array list are similar to one another. The only difference between the array list and linked list is that array list uses the dynamic array to store the elements, but in case of linked list uses the doubly linked list to store the elements. The storing process will be handled out internally, but in programming aspect both array list and linked list will perform in a similar manner. Let us have an example for linked list. Let us get into the next program, that is test Java collection 2. Let us get into the next program. So again, here rather than array list, we are using the linked list class. Here the object name is set as AL. The same process is repeating here, that is with the help of scanner class, we are going to receive the input and followed by the loop will be executed for n times and system.out.println I plus the element will be received and those elements can be added to the linked list object through the method called as add method. Similarly, In order to access the elements, we are in need of iterator class, here ITR is the object. So the al.iterator of will give you the reference to ITR object. The ITR.next of will display the element. So let us execute this program. Again, enter the number of elements. The linked list also allows the duplicate elements. Let us have the input as something ROM and ROM. We will display, we will get the output itself also as ROM and ROM. Because the linked list also allows the duplication. I repeat, both array list and linked list allow the duplication and they maintain the insertion order. So after linked list, we have discussed the concept called as vector. Let us get into the vector program. So you have to each and every time you have to right click the package. It may be a SRC package or it may be array list package. That's not a problem. In order to create each and every program, you have to right click and you have to move towards new, followed by you have to choose the class. In that class, you have to give the class name and you have to include the public static void method. So let us have a demo on vector. Here, the vector is the class. For the vector class, we have created the object B, followed by new to allocate the memory, a new vector of 3, 2. Which means that the initial capacity of the vector will be set as 3 and the incremented capacity will be 2. That is, after reaching the size of 3, that is after adding the 3 elements, the capacity will be incremented by 2 and the capacity will set as 5. So system.out.println of the initial size, we are going to get the initial size of the vector through size method and similarly initial capacity through capacity of method. So in order to add the element, we are going to use the method called as add element of new. Here the integer act as a wrapper class, new integer of 1. Now this 1 will be considered as integer data type. Similarly, we are going to do the same process for 4 times. That is, we are going to add the values 1, 2, 3, and 4 respectively to the vector B object. So after 4 addition, we are going to once again call the capacity of method. So after 4 addition, we are going to know what will be the capacity. And in order to access the first element, we are in need of method called as first element of. And in order to access the last element, there is a method called as last element of. If you want to check whether the particular element is available in the vector or not, then we have to use the method called as contains of. Here v dot contains of new integer of 3, so which will search for the integer value 3 in the vector object v, so that if the particular element is available, then the if part will be executed and the message will be displayed as system dot out, that is vector contains the element 3. We have already seen that the elements of the collection can be accessed either through iterator or through enumeration. So here, as a change, we are going to use enumeration concept to access the element of the vector. Enumeration, here v enum is the object, v dot elements of, so that the elements will be referenced through the object v enum. Now while of, rather than the method has next of in iterator, here we are going to use has more elements of method. In iterator, we have used the method that is has next of. In enumeration, we have to use the method called as has more elements of. If it has more elements, then system.out.println of the next element of will give you the element available in the vector. Let us execute the program. So the initial capacity, the initial size is set as 0 because at the starting of the time there is no more element in the vector. The first system.out.println says v dot size of, so the initial size that is 0. And when you get into the next println method, we are calling v dot capacity of method. So the v dot capacity of, the capacity is set as 3. So v dot capacity of will return the value as 3. And after adding the 4 elements, that is after reaching the size 3, when you are trying to add the 4th element, the increment part 2 will be added, 2 will be considered, so that 3 plus 2, the size will set as 5, that is the capacity will set as 5. So system.out.println capacity after 4 addition will give you the result as 5, because the initial capacity is 3. When you add the 4th element, the capacity will be incremented by 2 and the value will be 5. And v dot first element, the first element of, will return 1 as a result. That is, this will be the first element and the last element will be the 4. And v dot contains of integer of 3, yes, the element 3 is available. So 3 will be printed. And finally, with the help of enumeration, we are going to access the elements available in the vector. So the value will be, the values of the vector will be printed as 1, 2, 3, and 4 respectively. So the next concept we have discussed is stack. The stack is one of the subclass of the vector, that's also we have discussed. Let us have this program name as this Java collection 4, a simple program. Here for the stack class, we are going to create the object name as stack. This stack is different from this because here it is a stack class, that is here S is in cap. I am going to create the object in smaller case, that is stack as an object. Now in order to insert the element onto the stack, we are having the method called as push method. I am going to call the push method. With the help of push method, we are going to add the values as Ayush, Garvit, Amit, Asis, and Garima. That is 5 more values will be added together. And stack.popof will be called. We have already discussed the pop method will remove the element which is inserted last. So the Garima will be removed from the stack. After that, we are going to access the stack to the iterator. When you access the stack to the iterator, when you access the stack through iterator, we have seen that the iterator, the purpose of iterator is, the purpose of iterator is to access the element of the stack, to access the element of the collection. In order to access the element of the collection, we are in need of iterator. So when you use the same iterator for stack, it will access the item as it is. Let us execute the program. We will understand the difference. Is the output here? We have added the four elements, that is Ayus, Garbit, Amit, and Asis, and finally Garima. When you call the pop method, the Garima is removed. But when you use iterator method, the element of the stack will be accessed as it is. If you want to access the element of the stack as same as in the purpose of the stack, that is last in first out order, then you have to print the element by calling the pop method. Let us have system dot out dot print ln of stack dot pop off. When we execute this, the Garima, this is the element, that is the popped element, which will be printed first. After that, the same process will be continued. So let us have a for loop for I equal to 0. Let us execute the loop for 5 times. Now let us perform the operation save all. Here I is not declared. So here the error is shown to you, right? The I is not declared, so the error is shown to you. Let us declare the variable I. Now the error is removed. Let us give save all and let us execute the program. So when we execute this program, now the order will be last in first out order. So if you want to access the element in the order last in first out, then we have to use pop method, that popped value has to be printed. If you access the element of the stack as it is, rather than last in first out order, then you can use the iterator to access the elements as it is. I repeat, if you want to implement the stack and if you want to use the concept of the stack as it is, that is last in first out order, then you have to print the popped element. That is, you have to use the pop method. If you don't want to use the stack, if you don't want to access the stack in last in first out order, then you can use iterator to access the element as it is. Now, with the help of popoff, we have access to the element in last in first out order. So students,
sir, screenshot is not visible. Whether it's completed, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir.
Sir. Sir. Sir. Sir. Sir.
சார் இல்லைங்க சார், அடுத்த ப்ரோக்ராம் லோட் பண்ணுங்க சார்.
ஆ ஓகே ஓகே
ஒவ்வொரு ப்ரோக்ராம் லோடு கூடுதல் ஜாக்கம் சார்,
ஆ ஓகே
ஒரு
ஓகே
டூ செகண்ட்ஸ் லோட் ஆகுது. ஓகே
சரி ஒன்றும் பிரச்சனை சரி பண்ணுங்க.
If you use the priority queue, the next concept we are going to discuss is queue concept. The queue. In that queue, we are going to implement the class named as priority queue class. We have already come across the purpose of priority queue. The purpose of priority queue is in order to access, that is in order to store the element in some order. It may either be ascending order or descending order. By default, the elements will be enqueued and dequeued. The elements will be arranged in ascending order in priority. So now, let us get into the program part. So in order to remember, I have said that the purpose of priority queue is used to access the element in some priority, either as a min priority or as max priority. Sir?
So sharing is not done, sir.
Sir, link, sir. If you want to share, sir.
Okay, sir. Mr. Irman, you are sir.
Okay, sir. So now, let us have the class as create priority queue example. So in under that class, we are going to use priority queue. The priority queue itself as a class, which comes under the queue interface. Now numbers, the numbers is a object. New priority queue of will allocate the memory. Let us add the element in some order, that is 750, 500, 900, some random order. In some random order, we are going to enqueue the element onto the priority queue. So while of not numbers dot is empty, so that till the priority queue becomes empty, that while loop will be executed. Now, in system.out.println statement, we are going to print the elements. We are going to print the elements one by one. So, if you print the elements, you will get the output. In ascending order. Here system dot out dot println of members dot remove of. Now each and every element from the priority queue will be removed, but the elements will be stored in ascending order. So the element will be removed in ascending order itself. So wait a minute, let us execute the program.
Not visible, sir. Sharing.
Sir, okay. Okay, sir.
Just now it's disconnected, sir.
So when you execute this program, so the output will be in ascending order because the priority queue here, the elements will be stored in ascending order. Even though we add the elements in some random order, the elements will be arranged in ascending order itself. So after priority queue, we have discussed about a double ender queue. Let us get into the concept of double ender queue. So the in order to create the double ender queue, we are in need of class ArrayDQ or linked list form of DQ class. The DQ acts as an interface, which we have already seen. The DQ is the interface, sub interface of the queue interface. The DQ here means the double ender queue. DQ of here, the DQ is the object, new ArrayDQ of. Now the string, the class we are going to implement is ArrayDQ of. Now we are going to add the elements, that is enqueue the elements onto the queue through the add method. So as the element in the queue can be accessed in first in first out order, let us access the element as it is. Here for string str colon dq, this is called as enhanced for loop in Java. The purpose of enhanced for loop is in order to simulate the concept of for each loop. The for each loop is introduced in C#, that is in .NET framework. The for each loop was first introduced. In order to simulate the for each loop, the Java people uses the concept called as enhanced for loop. It is as similar to for each loop. So the enhanced for loop says for the string str colon dq, that is for each and every element of dq, each and every element of dq will be mapped to the object str. When you print str, you will get the element as it is. Let us execute the program. When you execute the program, the output will be Gautam, Karan and Ajay, that is the order. The queue says first in first out order has to be preserved. So when you execute this program, you will preserve the same order as it is. After the concept of queue, we have discussed the concept called as set. So when we come towards set, the set is the interface. The one point we have to remember in set is the set does not allow any duplication. So let us get into the program. into the program. The set is the interface, the hash set is the class. We have already discussed when you use the hashing technique, there is hash table to store the data. We are in need of hash set class. Hash set, the string indicates the data type, and here the set is the object name. Followed by new hash set string of, this is the constructor. So now we are going to add the elements one by one. Set.add method, in order to add the elements, we are in need of the method named as add, which we have discussed from first program itself. Here we are going to add the four elements, that is Ravi, Vijay. Once again, Ravi is added. Now let us execute the program. We have already seen that set does not allow duplication. So here the Ravi is added one more time. So when you execute this program, let us see what will happen. So Ravi, Vijay, Ravi and Ajay, we are trying to add the four elements, Ravi, Vijay and Ravi, Ajay. Similarly, with the help of iterator, we are going to iterate, that is traverse the elements of the collection. When we execute this program, so we come to know that only one Ravi is added, which means that in hash set, when you add the new duplicate, the older one will be replaced. That is, as a first Ravi will be added, followed by Vijay. When you try to add the Ravi once again, then the newer one, the newer duplicate will override the older one. So the first Ravi will be removed and now the newer Ravi will be added and Ajay will be added as it is. So the output will be Vijay, Ravi and Ajay. I repeat, in hash set, the newer duplicate will override or will remove the older one. But when you move towards the linked hash set, let us get into the second form of set. The second form of set interface, that is linked hash set. The linked list and the hashing concept will be inculcated in linked hash set class. Here, once again, we are going to add the same values, Ravi Vijay and Ravi Ajay. Once again, Ravi is duplicated for two times. When we execute this program, when we execute the linked hash set program, let us see what will be the output. I think you people are seeing the output. Here, the older duplicate Ravi will be preserved as it is. That is Ravi, Vijay, and third one, we are going to add the Ravi once again. Now, the newer duplicate will not be added. In case of hash set, the newer one will remove the older one. But in case of linked hash set, the older one will be preserved as it is. The newer one cannot be included. So that the third part, the third element, Ravi cannot be added because the Ravi is already added as a first element. So now the output will be Ravi, Vijay and Ajay. In case of hash set, if you use hash set, then the output will be Vijay, Ravi, Ajay because the newer duplicate will override the older one in hash set. But in case of linked hash set, the older one will not allow the newer one, that is, will not allow the newer duplicate to get onto the set.
So, screen share is stopped, sir.
Okay, sir.
Kindly share one second, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay. Sir, I am loading the, I am copying the next program, sir, so only.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So after hashes and linked hashes, we have discussed the concept called as tree set. The tree set comes under the concept called as sorted set interface. So we have already seen that tree set will arrange the elements in ascending order. Let us get into the program of tree set. Here tree set is the class, followed by set is the object, new tree set of. Here we are going to add the same elements, Ravi, Vijay and Ravi Ajay. Now we have already seen that the tree set will define the ascending order. So when you are defining the ascending order, when there is more than one duplicate, that duplicate will be removed as it is. Here we cannot say whether the older one replaces newer one or newer one replaces older one, because after adding all the elements, the tree set will arrange the element in ascending order. While arranging the element in ascending order, if there is more than one element repeated or replicated more than once, then the element will be removed. Let us execute the program. When we execute this program, the ascending order of the element is Ajay, Ravi and Vijay. So you will get the output as Ajay, Ravi and Vijay. I repeat, the tree set will arrange the elements in ascending order. The hash set, all the set concepts will not allow the duplicate. When we come towards the hash set, when you try to add the duplicate value onto the hash set, the newer one will remove the older duplicate. But when you come towards the linked hash set, the older one will not allow the newer duplicate. When we come towards tree set, it will arrange the element. By arranging the element, if there is more than one element, if there is more than one duplication, the duplicate will be removed. And finally, we have discussed the concept called as map. So we have discussed that the map is the concept which contains key value pair. That key value is called as entry. So now the map contains two parameters. So map followed by integer comma string. Now we are going to use the key as integer and the value as string. And map is the object. Now new hash map of. Here the hashMap class is used. HashMap of integer comma string. In order to insert the key and value onto the map, we are in need of method put method. With the help of put method, it is possible to add the key and value onto the map. So we have already discussed, we have already said that in order to traverse the map, we have to convert the map onto set. So that we are in need of interface called as map.entry. Entry is the sub-interface. So in order to traverse the element, we are in need of method called as entry setoff. The map.entry setoff will return each and every key value onto the map entry object. So with the help of enhanced for loop, the M contains, the object M contains the key value pair of the map. So in order to access the key, we are in need of method called as getKeyOf. And in order to access the value, we are in need of method called as getValueOf. So when we execute this program, the output will be a key value pair, that is 100 is the key and value is Amit. Similarly, 101 Vijay and 102 Rahul. So students, so we have discussed the list interface. When we come towards the list interface, we are having array list and linked list as the class. The both array list and linked list will allow the duplicate. When we come towards the vector class, the vector is synchronized one and it contains more methods when we compare to array list and linked list. That is the contents of method or the contents of method remove all. So those methods are not available in ArrayList. And then we have discussed the stack. Stack is one of the subclass of the vector. The stack, in order to insert the element onto the stack, we are in need of push method. And in order to access, in order to remove the element, we are in need of pop method. And when we come towards the interface named as cube, we are having the DQ interface, double-ended queue. From that double-ended queue, the double-ended queue interface can be implemented through the class ArrayDQ. And we can use priority queue class also in order to arrange, in order to store the element, in order to retrieve the element in ascending order. When we come towards set, the set does not allow duplication, but in case of list, it allows the duplication. When we come towards set, we are having three types of implementation. One is hashset, linked hashset, and tree set. The tree set will arrange the element in the ascending order, but in case of hashset and the linked hashset, there is no more arrangement. When we come towards hashset, the newer duplicate value will override or will remove the older one. But when we come towards the linked hashset, the older one will replace the newer one. And when we come towards map interface, the key value pair has to be maintained. The map does not allow the duplicate key, but it allows the duplication on value. That key value pair is called as entry. In order to traverse the map, we have to convert the map onto the set, so that we are calling the method called as entry set of method in order to access the key and value of the map. In order to print, in order to view the key, we are in need of method called as getKeyOf. In order to get the value, in order to know the value, we are in need of method called as getValueOf method.